In this video, you'll learn how to track a layer to a background in action. Even though this will be done in the Action Timeline effects, the steps will be the same in the main action compositor in ConnectFX. I'll navigate to the close-up of the gladiator, where I would like to add a title. You can create graphics and titles in Smoke, but it's common to be supplied with graphics from outside of Smoke to composite with. As a quick recap, let's switch to the Media Hub to import a graphic made in another application. I'll navigate to an image sequence with an embedded alpha channel. Notice that the Media Hub shows me the image sequence as a clip, which I can play and mark if I want. It is important to remember that Smoke will always treat the RGB and alpha channels separately. So in the case of a source with an embedded alpha, you could import the channels as separate clips. Or a better alternative is to create a matte container. The matte container contains both the RGB and alpha clips, and it is fully editable if required. In the General tab, change the clip options to Create Matte Container, and disable the Add Comp on Container. Normally, the Comp Timeline effects will key the alpha in the sequence. However, we will use the Action Timeline effects to do more than a simple key. And since Action is also a compositor, there is no need for the Comp Timeline effects on the matte container. I'll drag this image sequence into the library. Here's a tip. If your matte container already had a Comp Timeline effects applied to it, just turn it off in the effects pipeline when you use the Action Timeline effects. Returning to the timeline area, I'm going to edit the container clip over the background. Notice that the alpha channel information is disregarded and the graphic is not keying through the background. With the segment still selected, add an Action Timeline effects. The alpha is now active and it's keying over black. Remember to tell the Action Timeline effects to use the bottom video tracks as its background. To track this clip to the background, we need to go into the Action Editor. As you saw in the Action Basics video, I am using the 2-up view and the action schematic is assigned to the left view. The first step we're going to do is track the graphic to the gladiator. To track a layer in action, we use axis nodes. Double-click on the axis node to bring up its object controls. Next to the transformation controls, you will find the stabilizer button. This is the entry point into Smoke's 2D tracking tools. The options beneath the stabilizer are set up depending on the task. In this case, the stabilizer is set to track, and with rotation and scale turned off. Smoke will only track position. Ensure you are on frame 1. Click the stabilizer button to enter into the tool. In the viewer, click and drag the center of the tracker boxes to position them over part of the gladiator's uniform. Pressing the Analyze button will start the track and you can see the motion path being created. There are plenty of controls for more challenging tracks. However, in this case, the track was straightforward. Press the Return button to go back to the Action Timeline effects. When you scrub the time bar, you will see the surface is tracked to the gladiator. You can also see the keyframes in the time bar, as well as an animated X and Y position slider for the axis node. I must point out that the graphic has been centered on the tracking point that was used to analyze the background. So we need to reposition the graphic to its correct location in the shot. You can't edit the information in this axis node because it contains tracking data. In fact, select the node and change its name to Track. In order to offset the layer from its tracking information, we need to use another axis node. Switch to the Action Bin menu. This menu contains all the objects and components you can use in Action. Hover over the node bin and press A for axis. Click and drag an axis node directly into the Action schematic. If you haven't already done so, widen the gap between the original axis node and the image node. Now drop the new axis node above the image node. This should automatically insert it into the connection. For clarity's sake, let's rename this node to Offset. Next, double-click on the Offset node for its object menu. You are basically working on another level of animation beneath the tracking data. I'll scale the image object and reposition it to the screen right of the gladiator's face. Once the positioning is done, you can scrub the time bar to see how the tracking is working with the added position offset. The general rule is to always have your tracking data at the top and your offset data connected underneath. Please exit to return to the sequence. You can scrub or play the segment to preview the result. Press Render to process the final result. Please move on to the next video to continue your smoke getting started experience.